In today's video, you're going to learn how to create quick vertical split screens that you can use for Instagram Reels or TikTok. And today's video is sponsored by Epidemic Sound. I'll tell you more about them later on. For now, let's jump into Premiere Pro. First, from the project panel, we're going to go down to the little new item icon, select sequence. Now we can start with the digital SLR 1080p, but from settings, we're going to swap the horizontal and vertical. So the horizontal is going to be 1080 and the vertical is going to be 1920. So that way it's a 9x16 vertical sequence, and we can press OK. And now you can see we have our vertical sequence. Now Premiere Pro in version 2022.5 has a new vertical workspace. So if you're working in vertical video, go up here to the workspace dropdown and select vertical. And this will bring our program monitor on the right so we have a bigger view of the vertical frame. Now, the key to making successful split screens is using the guides. So when you have the program monitor selected, go up to view and show rulers and show guides. So you can see I have the rulers here. Now, what we're going to do is create a three split. If you click on the top ruler and you drag down, you can just create your first guideline. If you click on the left, you can create a vertical guideline. For this, we're just going to use the horizontal. But first, we need to do some math.
No, God!
1920 is the length of the width here. If we divide that by 3, it is, what was it again? 640. Yeah, that's 640. So the first guideline needs to be at exactly 640 pixels. So how do we get exactly that? Well, with this guideline out, we can press Control and click on it, select Edit Guide, and we can actually type in 640. Now we need to add 640 plus 640, which is 1280, and that will be the location of the next one. So click on the top ruler and drag down another one, Control click on it, and let's do 1280. So now we have our guidelines, which perfectly divides up our vertical video into three spaces, which is where we're going to place the video and apply a crop effect. That way they will nicely fit aligned to these guides. And there's a helicopter. So now I'm going to drag the video clips into the timeline stacked on top of each other. So this first clip here, I'm going to drag down into my timeline and then keep existing settings because we don't want to change it to horizontal. We want to keep it at vertical. And then let's drag this next video clip on top onto video layer 2, and then the last one on video layer 3. And let's Command L to delink the audio and delete that audio from that clip because we don't need audio in this case. So the first thing we need to do is just resize and place them into frame. So on video layer 3, let's say we want this to be up at the top. Using effect controls, we can move this clip up to be in our first guideline here and use the position controls to move it over and maybe scale him down a bit so we can see all three lights there. And then we need to apply a crop effect. So go to effects and search for crop and double click to apply it to the clip. And now we have our crop here in effect controls and we want to crop the bottom. So if we just click and drag, we can have it meet exactly at this guideline. So that's looking good. Now let's work on the bottom one here. So video 2, scale this one down and let's bring this down to the bottom guideline. And then we can move it over and that looks good. And we don't need to apply a crop for this instance because it fits nicely in the frame, but you can always apply a crop if you have to. And then for the bottom layer, we can just scale this down until it fits into frame. And for this one, we also don't need a crop because the other two layers cover it up. So it's good to go. And then we can just press C and shift to cut off the excess of the top two layers and delete that. And now we have our three split video with our little dancer guys having a good time here. So now that our videos are in place, we can go to the program monitor, go up to view, and we can actually go ahead and save the guides as a template. So we can call this three split vertical. So that way at any time you want to bring up those split screen guides, just go up to view, guide templates, and select three split vertical and they will appear. And by the way, my name is Kelsey. If this video is helping you out so far, be sure to give it a thumbs up as well as subscribe. If you're looking for a ready-made pack of 15 plus split screen templates for Premiere Pro, ready-made for Instagram Reels and TikToks, I've made exactly that. It's available on premieregal.com/store. Once you download the template pack, you can import it into any existing Premiere Pro project that you have open in the project panel. And then you can open up the folder for the exact split screen you want to use, and then open up the placeholder and drag and drop in your own videos or photos to use the split screen templates. And instead of using guides slides in the crop effect, I've made ready-made placeholders. So all you have to do is choose the split screen you want to use and then open up the placeholder and drag and drop in your own media. You'll find different variations for 2 splits, 3 splits, 4 splits, 5 splits, 6 splits, 7 splits, actually no 7 splits, 8 splits, 10 splits, and 2 bonus split screens for before and after effects if you want to show a shot before and then after. If you want to use the same split screen twice in the same project, you can just re-import the template project file into your project panel as many times as you want. So you can take all these split screens that I've designed and drag them into one timeline to design a really cool music video for Instagram, for example. I've downloaded a track from Epidemic Sound called Remember These Days. It's a really nice old hip-hop soundtrack, and I really love Epidemic Sound because it has really cool old-school hip-hop as well as electronic and pop music that I use on my YouTube videos, and it's really great because it's royalty-free, and you can download an unlimited number of tracks to test out in your videos, and it's safe for social media and YouTube, so you don't get any copyright strikes. If you'd like to use this exact track that I'm using, you can sign up for a 30-day trial of Epidemic Sound using my link below, and you can download as much as you want to try out in your own videos. So what I've done is I've taken a bunch of the split screen templates from my pack and I've placed them into one timeline and cut it to the beat of this music track. So you can see here I have all the placeholders ready, and all I have to do now is open up these split screen templates and drag in my own media. So I'm gonna quickly go ahead and do that, and then I will show you the final result. All right, so I placed all of the videos in the placeholders, and this is the result. If you want to export this video for Instagram or TikTok, go to the export workspace. And I like to use MatchSource Adapt Bitrate. If you don't see that here, you can go to more presets and you'll be able to search here and find it and add it to your list. And the format I use, it's H.264. That is best for Instagram and TikTok. And then just hit export. That's all for today's video. And if you have any questions, be sure to leave a comment below. Again, special thanks to Epidemic Sound for sponsoring today's video. Remember, you can get 30 days free of their music by clicking right here. And if you want to learn some more Instagram real tricks, you can click right over here. And as always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.